There's a Christmas tree in the apartment! Yay! We're gonna decorate it. Drum groups became holiday festive-ish, but it definitely is, because since the beginning of December, there have been 4 drum shows on my street, which is fine. A little loud, but festive, and, you know, energizing. People get really excited. Check it out. Stay and watch the whole thing this time, because, you know, been there, done that. And this group isn't as, like, exciting or flamboyant as the other group was when there was, like, the big Christmas market on the street, but still really cool and enthusiastic, so it's cool. In other news, there's a Christmas tree in my apartment, and it's kind of not lit well from that side, so I can't really show it to you in extreme detail, but that's it. It's, like, it comes up to, here on me. So it's a cute little shrimpy tree. Nice and bushy. We're calling it Cindy. Like Cindy Lou Who. Isn't that cute? She smells great. It's actually like a real tree, a real pine tree, which I haven't had in a really long time. And I got some, decorations for her. I went with the red and gold theme. So we've got red and gold bobbly bits, and then a red star to put on top. So, should be cute, and I'm not going to decorate it tonight because my friend Ingrid wants to partake in the decorations, and she has never celebrated, well, I think she celebrated Christmas once before, but she's from a Jewish family, so Christmas is not so much of a thing for her yet, but she's really excited to experience it, and we're all excited to experience it in Paris. And step number one is apparently a drum show, and then step number two is a tree. And then step number three is, I mean, let's be honest, we're all 20-somethings, so step number three does involve a little bit of grog. This isn't grog. It is, what are you? Sommer Anne de la Renardier, excuse me. Focus, please. There you are. In any case, it's a sparkling wine, and it's a Brut, so not the sweet kind, but the kind of tart kind, which is what I definitely prefer. And essentially the plan is Ingrid, Addie, and Addie's boyfriend James are all going to come over for Christmas on Christmas Day, and we're going to have dinner and hang out and drink wine and play games and essentially be merry. And it's going to be really fun, and I also bought some wrapping paper, because, spoiler alert, presents! What else can I tell you? Oh, I did Secret Santa with some of my friends here in Paris, with some of the lecteurs, and my friend Niall's roommates were in on it as well. So I gave my friend Sarah a sachet of, like, really nice tea of Earl Grey. And it turns out Sarah had my name, so she gave me a mug that you can chalk right on with chalk. So, right now it says, I heart my mama. So, shout out to my mom. Hey, you know who you are. But check it. I can also write things like, it's hard to write with chalk. Bubble! Hey, because why not? And so she also gave me some chalk to go along with it. And when I opened the package, I got the chalk first before I got to the mug, and I was like, oh, thanks. But, I mean, I know I'm a teacher, but most of my classrooms have whiteboards, so thanks. And then it made more sense. And then inside, these are also chocolates that are in the shape and guise of umbrellas. so it's pretty cute. And I didn't film that just because my camera battery was dead and I don't have a spare, which is naughty of me. I should be better about that. What else has been going on? Oh, I've got my advent calendar going strong. I already ate today, so you can't see what it looks like. But I think I only have 4 days left, because today's the 20th. Oh, God. 21, 22, 23, 24. So, yeah, you can see, like, there was definitely a pattern in opening all of the boxes. Because now there's, like, a little unopened bit here. And it all seems to be Santa. It's all Santa that has to be opened. So I see what's going on here. Put you back. What else has been... Did I just cover up the microphone? No, it's fine. What else has been happening? On Thursday I had to go to it's kind of a combination between a doctor's office and a government visa office. It's called OFI, the Office Français de l'Immigration et de l'Intégration, which essentially means anybody who's not a member of the European Union has to go to this office and get a basic medical screening to make sure that they're not going to spread, like, tuberculosis around France. And it's kind of ridiculous because all they make you do, all they do is, like, take your height and weight. They take, like, a blood sample. It's like a finger prick. And then they do an x-ray of your lungs. And that's it. Well, I mean, and then they have, like, a general consultation with the doctor who just says, like, are you feeling ill? Are you single? Does anybody in your family have, like, diabetes? And, you know, pretty much question and answer, and then they take your blood pressure, which I don't think, like, rules out absolutely every illness in, you know, known to mankind, so it doesn't seem the most effective of screenings. Then again, I wouldn't have wanted to do anything more, because that appointment plus the time waiting to get my visa sticker in my passport took about 3.5 hours, and by the end, I was just, like, dying of boredom. But it was necessary because in order to remain a resident here in France and not a long-term tourist, which you can only be for, I think, it's either 2 weeks or 2 months, I can't remember. So you need, like, a special sticker in your passport to say that you're allowed to be there for longer than a tourist would. So without getting too close, so you can't see any information, this is what it looks like. All of that for this. It was worth it, I guess, because I needed it. Okay. I haven't really eaten anything today. No, I ate a banana, but, you know. I'm going to go see The Hobbit tonight with Ingrid and Addie, but before that I really need to eat something. So I got a baguette, or a kind of baguette called a tradition, or traditional, and I'm going to eat it with some soup, because I have a vegetable puree soup. I think I have some cheese, too. And I will try to film more of Christmas. I've been kind of lax on filming lately because with, like, finals and everything. Oh, by the way, I'm done with my semester, my grad school semester. I got an A in my intro to translation seminar, and I'm still waiting on a final grade for theory, but I tallied up all of the scores that I got from my assignments, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to get an A there. So, yay, Merry Christmas to me. Okay, this is a long enough recording. Bye! We are not going to see a movie tonight, which was originally the plan. Instead, we're going to wait until Monday, because today's Saturday. So we're going to wait until Monday so we can get more discounts, saving money. And in the meantime, we are going to decorate the tree tonight. Yay! It's going to be really fun. So Cindy, you're getting a makeover. My only thing is, I don't have Christmas lights, like twinkle lights. And I'm kind of sad about it. I kind of wish that I did. Just because, well, maybe I can get them. Christmas shopping is not over yet. They just didn't happen to have them in the little convenience store that I went to. But they probably have some at, like, really any store that's bigger than my apartment. So I'll keep my eyes out. And in the meantime, we'll do the baubles and the star on top. And it'll be a great intermediate. This makes 5. Which is kind of nice because usually And it's weird that I get to say usually, but usually the train processions stop right in the square right outside of my window and perform for like 10 or 15 minutes, and it's cool the first time, and then it gets really loud, so I'm kind of relieved that they kept going. But, yeah. 5 times, and these guys were very, very focused, very serious. They take Christmas very seriously.
Good enough.
Ingrid's gonna decorate her first Christmas tree! Ah! Wherever you want it to go. Yeah, don't stab yourself. Yeah! Perfect!
Bravo.
You didn't fuck that up. We're very proud of you.
Nah,
nobody cares.
You're just supposed to stab it through the top. Yeah, you're supposed to like, well, maybe we have to like trim the top down a little bit.
Yeah.
Wait. Okay, go ahead. Cindy, you're being all crooked.
Yay!
Yay!